Thanks for joining us. We start with a major development in a case that's received a lot of attention the past few years. Attorney General Keith Ellison's office has charged a former Minneapolis police officer with assaulting a man during the riots that followed George Floyd's murder. Danny Spiewak joins us tonight to explain what happened. Danny?
Well, Chris, we've learned tonight that former MPD officer Justin Stetson has not been employed by the department since August. Now he's also charged with third-degree assault, the latest twist in a case that prompted even more calls for police accountability.
On the fourth night of riots following the murder of George Floyd, body camera video shows MPD officers in an unmarked SWAT van firing rubber bullets at people out past curfew on Lake Street. At one point, the video shows someone returning fire with a gun. The man who returned fire, a legal gun owner named Jaleel Stallings, was initially charged with felonies, including attempted murder. But a jury acquitted him, arguing he acted in self-defense because he didn't know that the people shooting rubber bullets were police officers. Here's Stallings explaining.
I heard what to me sounded like a gunshot, felt an extremely hard impact, hit my chest, which at the time, based on what was going on, I assumed was a bullet.
When Stallings says he realized it was police, surveillance video shows him laying down to surrender. Next, prosecutors identify former officer Justin Stetson as the person seen kicking Stallings on the ground. The AG's office has now charged Stetson with third-degree assault, alleging that he kicked, punched, and slammed Stallings' head on the pavement. The AG's law enforcement expert found that Stetson's use of force was, quote, unreasonable, excessive, and contrary to generally accepted police practice.
We definitely welcome the Attorney General's decision to charge.
Jaylani Hussein with the Council on American Islamic Relations has led calls for accountability in this case for months.
Third degree charge here is appropriate. Obviously, we could charge more, but I think it also shows that we do need independent prosecution.
Stallings got a $1.5 million settlement from the city last year, but his attorney says they don't have a comment yet on the charge against Stetson.
Minneapolis police also declined comment tonight, and we reached out to the police union in Minneapolis and the association representing officers across the state of Minnesota, but neither have responded. Stetson's peace officer's license in Minnesota is no longer active. Chris.
All right. Thank you, Danny.